Saku Mocha Takeri no Cross the Shinobi World as the White Fang was drawn in Okonoha's Hatake clan. Sakuma was a famous and powerful ninja of Konoha, who, during his lifetime, held fame that was said to overshadow even that of the legendary Sannin. His son Kakashi proved himself a genius, like Sakuma, and idolized him, desiring to become just as great ninja as his father. His wife died when Kakashi was very young. Sakuma witnessed his son successfully passing the entrance exam to enter the academy. Afterwards, he and Kakashi met Mai Dai and his son Gai. Sakuma politely asked Gai to be friends with Kakashi in the academy, but Dai corrected Sakuma, informing him that his son had failed the exam. As Kakashi began to openly question Gai's worth as a ninja with his weak aptitude for ninjutsu, Sakuma warned Kakashi to not underestimate Gai, as he may someday grow even stronger than Kakashi, noticing how hard Gai trained to improve. At some point in time during his career as a shinobi, Sakuma confronted and killed Sasori's parents, earning Chiyo's hatred. While his son was still in the academy, Sakuma and his team were sent on a mission of great importance to Konoha. When his teammates' lives were endangered, Sakuma chose to abandon the mission in order to save them. The impact of the mission's failure caused Sakuma to be vilified by the Land of Fire, the villagers of Konoha, and even those he had saved. Dishonored, Sakuma fell into deep depression, which caused his abilities to suffer as a result. Eventually, he committed suicide, and later was buried in Konoha Cemetery. For many years, Sakuma stayed in limbo, waiting for the day he could seek forgiveness from his son, Kakashi. Sakuma was a very kind and loyal man. He loved his only son dearly, often picking him up at the end of the day after Kakashi was done playing with his friends. Despite his tremendous fame and power as a ninja, he was a very humble man, which made Kakashi truly look up to him and idolize him even more. He had a deep devotion to Konoha and even greater commitment to his allies and loved ones, to the point where he would put their well-being before anything else. His commitment was so great that he would sacrifice the completion of a mission in order to save his teammates, which led to him becoming a public figure of hate and ridicule. He was also shown to be a perceptive man, noticing Guy's worn-out condition and correctly predicting that Guy was a late bloomer and his future growth as a ninja. Sakuma had a kind face with dark eyes, which had deep lines running underneath them. He had spiky, silver-colored hair that reached into the middle of his back, tied into a ponytail, and bangs that hung over his forehead protector. He wore the standard Konoha uniform with a pair of gloves, flak jacket, bandages on his right arm, and the additional distinctive short white sleeve, which had red edges and the standard crest of Uzushio Gakure on it, ninjas who were famous for their full ninjutsu, aka swimming techniques. He also carried a holster worn diagonally over his right shoulder, which held his white light chakra saber. Overall, Kakashi bears such a great resemblance to him that he was even mistaken for his father on several different occasions. Sakuma was hailed as the genius shinobi and was praised for his talents in the ninja arts even by the likes of Minato Namikaze, the future 4th Hokage. In the battle, Sakuma was a truly powerful shinobi, and in his time, his powers were said to be on par with even those of the legendary Sannin. The mere idea of facing Sakuma brought fear to his enemies, as shown from the reaction of Iwagakure Shinobi, who mistook Kakashi for the White Fang. He was also very proficient in Kenjutsu, aka the Sword Art. His reputation as Konoha's White Fang, stemming from his extensive use of the White Light Chakra Saber, which emitted a streak of the White Chakra when swung. After Kakashi died, having used up all of his remaining chakra to save Choji Akimichi from the Asura Pad's missile during the Pain's assault on Konoha, He found himself in the area of darkness with a single campfire, where Sakumo greeted his son and invited him to share his life story with him. Sakumo lamented that they both died too young, though not as young as his wife. Kakashi said that he understood the sacrifice that Sakumo had made for the sake of the villagers, which shocked Sakumo. He also finally forgave him and told him that he was proud of him and what he had done, which prompted Sakumo to thank Kakashi. When a ray of light beamed down upon Kakashi, Sakumo told Kakashi that it seemed that he still had a lot of the things to do in the world of the living, and said that he was glad that he was able to speak with him again, and was thankful that his son had forgiven him. After Kakashi disappeared, Sakumo stated that he could finally move on in peace, and after a long time, finally see his wife again. His suicide drove Kakashi to live strictly according to the shinobi rules. Despite being disgraced for his actions during his last mission, Sakumo's name still had a good standing throughout the shinobi world, as displayed when the Fire of Feudal Lord seemed pleased when Kakashi was recommended to be the 6th Hokage, having recognized him as Sakumo's son. The 3rd Tsuchikage also identified Kakashi as Sakumo's son when the Kage were deciding on whom they wanted to represent Konoha in the Shinobi Alliance. Obito Uchiha, Kakashi's teammate, also greatly respected Sakumo for his beliefs that his comrades' lives were to be placed before the outcome of a mission or the rules of the Shinobi. Although Kakashi initially tried to live his life in the exact opposite way Sakumo did, his friendship with Obito changed his perspective, leading him to believe that while those who break the rules are scum, those who abandon their comrades are even worse than scum. Kakashi would later teach these ideals to his students, especially to Naruto Uzumaki, who would cherish and use them as the basis for most of his life ideals. Gio remained bitter of Sakumo for killing Sasori's parents despite knowing about his death, and even attempted to attack his son Kakashi 21 years later, mistaking Kakashi for the White Fang during their incredible resemblance. She held off the attack once her brother Ebizo reminded her that Sakumo died, but was shocked to hear that Kakashi is the White Fang's son. And finally, some trivia surrounding his name. The name Sakumo is possibly derived from the word Sakumotsu, meaning agricultural produce or crops. This would tie into the name of his son, Kakashi, which means scarecrow, and their family name, Hatake, which means farmland. And the final quote he said to Kakashi: "I am grateful that we had time to talk, and for your forgiveness. At long last, I can move on in peace. Then finally, see your mother."